Welcome to Communication Engineering playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain ring modulator, or even it is referred as a chopper modulator, that is to utilize for a generation of DSBSC signal. So here in this session, I'll be explaining DSBSC signal generation by ring modulator. So in this session, I'll explain you circuit of ring modulator first. Then I'll explain two different modes of working which is there with ring modulator. Then we will observe waveforms which is there with ring modulator, that will explain you how ring modulator functions. So let us begin this session with basic circuit. So when you see DSBSC generation by ring modulator, its circuit is this, where this is primary winding, and at input of primary winding there is modulating signal, and then there are four diode that is connected like this. Two diodes directly from anode to cathode and two diodes from cathode to anode with cross connection. So that is how we are connecting diodes here. These two transformer are center tap transformer, where we connect over here carrier signal. So we connect carrier signal over here at center tapping of this transformer, and at the output side of transformer T2 will be having output, and that output will be DSBSC output. Now how that output will be DSBSC output, that you will come to know later on. First of all, when we talk about working of this circuit, that functioning of this circuit, that is happening in two modes. One is without modulating signal and second is with modulating signal. But before I explain you working of this circuit, few basics that you need to understand. One basic is, here this circuit is completely functioning based on carrier signal. So when this carrier signal that is giving some magnitude positive of this terminal with respect to this, then based on that, this diode will come in forward bias or reverse bias. The reason is, value of carrier signal that is far greater than modulating signal. So magnitude of carrier signal that will justify on and off of this diode which is connected in this circuit. So basically four diodes are there, and all four diodes are getting triggered based on carrier signal. So this is what one need to understand. Based on carrier signal only, there will be polarity of diodes. So here I'll be explaining two modes. One is without modulating signal. So let us try to understand what happens without modulating signal. So when we talk about without modulating signal, it means modulating signal, by blue color I am showing it, that is 0. XT, that is 0. Now I will consider first case where this carrier signal is having this terminal positive with respect to this terminal. So when this carrier signal is having this terminal positive with respect to this terminal, we'll be finding, like, see, this positive that is connected here, it means D1 and D2 that will come in forward bias. The reason is anode of D1 and D2 that is positive with respect to cathode. So D1 and D2 diode that will come in forward bias, and D3 and D4 diode that will come in reverse bias. So here D1 and D2 that is in forward bias, and D3 and D4 that is in reverse bias. In case of carrier signal is positive by this terminal with respect to this terminal. So what will happen is, from this carrier there will be flow of current in this direction. So current direction that will be this. Now this current now that will pass through D1 and it will come here, and this current that will pass through D2 and that will come here, and magnitude of current that is same. The reason is this transformer are center tap transformer. So impedance is equal in both of the direction. So current direction will be this and its magnitude is same. So what happens is this current that will cancel each other. This current that will cancel each other. So because of this current is cancelling each other, resultant magnitude of output that will be zero. So output will be zero. So here what is happening? Here carrier is getting suppressed, ideally that we can say. So here carrier is getting suppressed, ideally that is what we can say over here. Now let us consider second case. Even in that input signal xt is equals to 0. Now when xt is equals to 0 and if I say ct that is positive over here with respect to this, it means this is what positive terminal with respect to this. So as if this terminal is positive with respect to this, over here if I say this is positive with respect to this, it means D1 and D2 that will come in reverse bias. And D3 and D4, you can see positive means D4 and D3 that will come in forward bias. So D1 and D2 that is in reverse bias and D4 and D3 and D4 that is in forward bias. So D1 and D2 that is in reverse bias, so it is off, and D3 and D4 that is in forward bias, so that is on. So what happens is, you can see as this terminal is positive with respect to this, current that will flow in this direction from this carrier signal, and now it will be in this loop like this, and from here it will be in this loop, and over here one can see direction of current that will be in this direction as one can see. So ultimately what will happen here? Here current direction that is in opposite and equal. So resultant magnitude at output side that will be again zero. The reason is these two current are in opposite direction and it is cancelling each other. So as this current is cancelling each other, output will be zero in case of mode 1. So this is what I have explained right now. In mode 1, output is 0 provided modulating signal is 0. Even though carrier signal is there, output is 0. It means carrier is getting suppressed. So our aim is DSBSC generation, means SC means suppressed carrier. So carrier should get suppressed, and here that is happening. So this is what mode 1 operation, in which carrier is getting suppressed. Now let us consider second mode, that is mode 2. So by this green color I am explaining mode 2. Now in mode 2 there will be message signal. In mode 2 there will be message signal. So if I say message signal, now in mode 2 message signal where xt is positive, it means this is positive with respect to this. It means this is positive with respect to this. So as I have told you, biasing of diode will get justified by carrier signal. So what will happen is, as this terminal is positive with respect to this, what will happen is this signal now that will flow in this direction through this diode D1 and D2. So see, this positive will get translated over here, positive, and this negative will get translated over here, negative. So positive, negative, that is how output will appear. So our output will be positive if input is positive, and that will get multiplied by carrier signal. So output is positive and it will get multiplied by carrier signal and it will appear over here. Now see, over here if I say input is negative, it means if input is negative, It means this terminal is negative with respect to this terminal. It means this will be positive and this will be negative. So now see, this positive that will appear over here and this negative that will appear over here. Right? So here polarity is reverse. Right? Minus plus, and here it is appearing plus minus. Why that is happening? The reason is modulating signal is negative. Right? So ultimately one can conclude like this: if carrier signal is positive, modulating signal is positive, output cycle will be positive. If modulating signal is positive, carrier signal is negative, output cycle will be negative. If modulating signal is negative, carrier signal is positive, output cycle will be negative. If modulating signal is negative, carrier signal is negative, output cycle will be minus minus, that will be plus. See, that is how output will get appear, and this is what one can understand like this. So let us try to understand that by waveforms. So see, here one can see this is modulating signal and this is carrier signal. Now this carrier signal is high frequency signal and modulating signal is low frequency signal. And as I have told you, modulating signal will get multiplied with carrier signal. So here modulating signal is positive, carrier signal is positive, so output will be positive and it will appear like this. Right? And I am just showing you by this dark color. So dark color means both are positive, so D1 and D2 that will get trigger. So I am just showing you this by this dark color. Like, see, in that case D1 and D2 that will get trigger. Now see, here modulating signal is positive and carrier signal is negative. So output will be negative. So it will be this. And in that case, that D2 and D3 that will get trigger. So here I am mentioning it by blank space, D3, D4 on. Right. Now see, again modulating signal positive, carrier signal positive. Modulating and carrier signal both are positive, so output will appear like this. Over here modulating signal is positive, carrier is negative, so it will appear like this. And that is how it is keeps on repeating. And in this case, modulating signal is positive and carrier signal is negative. So that is how it appears like this, right? Now see, over here, when negative half cycle is there. So during negative half cycle, modulating signal is negative and carrier signal is positive. So if modulating signal is negative and carrier signal is positive, so output will be negative. Right? So it will appear like this. And if modulating signal is negative, carrier signal is negative, so in that case output will appear positive like this. But here D1 and D2 that will get trigger, while over here D3 and D4 that will get trigger. So that one should take care of. And this is what keeps on repeating. And here one can see output is getting multiplied with modulating signal. Output is multiplication of carrier signal and modulating signal. So that is how output is appearing. So you can observe it like this. Right? So this is what primary T2 signal. That is what primary input T2 signal. Now, what will be secondary T2 signal? So that will happen in that way only. But as here LC combination is happening, you will not observing this type of sharp edges. It will be looks like sine wave. So we'll be finding it is appearing like sine waves like this, right? Where these are cycles where D1 and D2 1, and these are the cycles where D1 and D2 1, and this blank is for D3 and D4 on. So that is how output is appearing in ring modulator, that is even referred as chopper modulator. So here few basic points that one should understand. First point is entire circuit is having biasing based on carrier signal. So carrier signal will justify which diode will come in forward bias and which diode will come in reverse bias. So in first mode I have explained operation of this circuit without modulating signal, means modulating signal is zero. By blue color you can see functioning, where current is getting cancelled at output side, means suppressed carrier is happening even though carrier signal is present. In second mode with modulating signal I have explained functioning, where polarity of this diode that will be as per carrier signal, right? But output will be positive or negative, that is based on multiplication. So if carrier positive, modulating signal is positive, output is positive, D1, D2 on. If carrier is negative, input is negative, D2, D3 on, output will be negative, positive, sorry, output will be positive. You can see negative input, negative carrier, output is positive, D2, D3 on. So here these are the various combinations that we need to understand. And I can mention that to have better clarity, like see, MT and CT, where if MT is positive, CT is positive, D1, D2 on. If MT is negative, carrier is negative, D3, D4 on, right? D3, D4 on. Here even output is positive. Here even output is positive. And these are diode. If modulating signal is positive, carrier is negative. So one can see if modulating signal is positive, carrier is negative. So in that case, D2, D3 will on and output will be negative. So in that case, D2, D3 will be on. And output will be negative. So ultimately carrier signal is, if carrier signal is positive, D1, D2 is on. If carrier signal is negative, D3, D4 is on. And multiplication will justify what will be output. So see, if minus plus is there, carrier signal is plus, means D1, D2 is on and output will be negative. So that is how output is appearing, that one should understand. And I have shown it by waveforms even. So you just do practice along with me. Probably you can easily understand this. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give me your valuable suggestions regarding what is required over here in sessions. And you can tell me one thing. I want to know that, like see, I have made videos by placing content on paper, I have made videos by tab, and now I am making videos on board. So out of this three category, which is more efficient to understand over here online, please let me know, give me feedback regarding this. I am asking this to my students even. I just want better resolution in teaching and learning. So if you give me your valuable suggestions, definitely I'll be able to optimize this channel and there will be better teaching with our students. So please give your valuable suggestions. Thank you so much for watching this video and share it with your friends so that even they can even get this benefit of study online. Thank you so much for watching this video.